Hi guys, welcome back to my channel Testing Money Bytes. I am your friend Amuthan Shaktivel, and today we will have the solution for our long existing issue with parallel execution, right? So we are facing some issue with parallel execution in our Selenium framework. We will try to resolve that. We understood, you know, why it is happening. We'll try to resolve that today. Okay, to do that, we will take the help of ThreadLocal class, which is a class available in Java itself. Okay, so we'll understand what is ThreadLocal. Okay. First, you know, this ThreadLocal class helps us to create variables that can be read and written by the same thread. Okay, it can be read and written by the same thread. Only the thread which sets the value can be able to read from it. Okay, if some other thread is trying to come and access it, it will not have any access. So even though we maintain only one ThreadLocal variable, okay, it still do the purpose for us. Okay, it is the easiest way available to safeguard your static class variables from multiple threads. Again, we'll also see in today's video how we can create a thread local variable, what is the default value of a thread local variable, and we'll also see there are three methods: get, set, and remove. And as an optional subject, we'll also see how we can change the default value of a thread local variable. And we also see what is inheritable thread local. Again, these two are optional. So if you do not want to learn it, that's completely all right. But it's just to add at the point from my side. Okay. So let's get into the learning about thread local. Consider, you have to give you a clean picture. What I've done, I have compared a thread local to your child care home. Okay. If you notice, we have mentioned child care home here. Okay. So whatever the thread we have, we are comparing it with parent one, and then thread two is your parent two. Okay, what this child care home will do? So suppose consider both of your parents are going to office. They want to someone to take care of their child, right? What they do, they take their child to the child care home and then drop them there in the morning, right? So what this thread local will do, what your child care home will do, it will take care of the kids, assigned to them from the morning till the evening, till their parents come and take their kids back home, right? No other parents can come, and take other child, right? So the thread one, same way, your thread one can only access the driver one, whatever the driver instance that it created. Your thread two can only access whatever the driver it created. Okay, just a simple analogy that I could see. I hope you all can understand, right? So even though we have only one thread local variable, okay, so we will try to see it in the code now. Okay, good. So let's go get back to the thing that we are doing. So what I have done, I have also created some demo code for you so that we can understand how it is. Okay, this is a basic code, right? So it's like a normal variable, like how you declare your int a equal to 5, something like this. Okay, the same way you need to declare like this. Okay, I have created as a private static, and this is the thread local, right? The class, and this class is accepting a generic. So suppose if I don't give this, it'll ask me to, it'll show warnings. Okay, please give generics, because this thread local should be given with the generics, like what kind of value we are storing there. In my case, now I am storing, for example, we are storing something like string. Okay. And let me name the thread local variable as ATM. Okay. This is a new example that I want to tell, and give the new thread local. Again, from Java 1.7, if you given the generics in the left hand side, it is automatically understood and you don't have to mention it in the right hand side. Good. So we have three methods, right? As I already told, we have three methods. One is get method. If the parent goes and then tell get, okay, what this variable will do, it'll bring them the child and then hand it over to them. Okay, this get method will do the same thing. Okay, there is a set method, which means if the parents coming to the home in the morning, they have to bring and the kid with them, and then they have to assign it to this child care home. Okay, but here I am taking an example of ATM so that it will be more interesting. Okay, so what does the ATM does? Okay, whoever deposits the money into their account, they can only come and collect the money. So if even if someone comes, they doesn't know, okay, they will, it will not allow, the ATM will not allow, it will do a lot of authentication and it will not allow you to take the money from there. Okay, so suppose if you want to deposit money, you can go and deposit money. Again, there is something called as remove. To tell, you know, to explain this better, what I have done, okay, I have installed a plugin called a Sonar Lint, okay. Please install this. If you don't have, please go to the Sonar, you know, Eclipse Marketplace, install this Sonar Lint plugin. It's a very, very simple task, but it can give you a lot of good things, okay. I can go, I already installed this. I'm going to the installed tab and then, you know, I'll tell you why we need Sonar Lint, okay. It will help you to write much clean code, okay. The Sonar Lint is IDE extension. In my case, you know, it's already installed, so it's showing me update option. So if you want, you can also install this, but I would highly recommend to install this. This will definitely help you to write better codes, okay. So previously when I was using ThreadLocal, I was not using this remove method. So whenever I want to get the money, I use the get method. When I want to set some value, I use set method. If I want to close my bank account with the bank, what I do, I normally set it back to, I'll pass a null here. Okay, I'll set it back to null. But the thing is, okay, after I started using Sonar Lint suggested me something. Okay, so it's telling call remove on ATM. So it's asking, so let's click on the open description of the rule. So if you notice, okay, this description states, see, ThreadLocal's variables are supposed to be garbage collector, holding that is no longer alive. Memory leaks can occur when holding threads are reused, which in the case, we are not using any pool of threads, but yeah, normally garbage collector will do the purpose. But if it is not, there can be a chances that it can also cause memory leaks, okay? To avoid such problems, it is always good to clean your ThreadLocal variables by remove method. So instead of taking all the money from your bank, making it a zero balance, it's always good to go and tell the bank, okay, I want to close my account, write a form, you know, sign it and hand it over to the manager so that we are completely, you know, closing the whole thing, okay? Otherwise, if you're having zero balance in your account, you think, okay, I have closed my account. But the problem is there can be cases they may charge you for zero balance, right? The same way, they are telling us to use this remove method, okay? So this is the thing. So this Sonar Lint helps me, you know, to understand all these things, okay? If you want to learn more about it, they also given a link here, okay? So they also given a non-compliant code here, okay? Where they have it used. So see, they are using null to set it. Okay, null to set it back to null. But the thing is, here they started using a method called unload, and they also started using method remove to safely remove the ThreadLocal variable value. Okay, so that's why I strongly suggest please try to use this particular plugin. Okay, now we know also understand what how to use this. Again, let's get back to the project, what we are working, and then we'll try to implement the same thing. Here we have used a string here, but in our case, it will be a web driver. Okay, let's now get into the project. This is the driver class that we have. Okay, so this is our static variable. So what I'm going to do, we're going to have a replica copy of this. Okay, but the thing is, we're going to change wherever the string, we are going to change it with driver. Okay, so let's keep it as private, static. And this time ThreadLocal, I'm going to create an object for ThreadLocal, the variable web driver, yeah, and I can name it as dr, maybe new ThreadLocal. Okay, again, I don't have to give like this, it's just a variable, guys. So in this I have to create a getter and setter method. Okay, so I can name create a getter method now. So this getter method will return me a web driver instance, right? Because I'm storing a web driver thing there, because my generics is web driver, right? So I can name this thing as get driver, okay, for more readability. Again, it is asking me to return something. So let's return dr.get, okay? Whatever the driver instance you are storing inside the ThreadLocal variable, okay? Here the ThreadLocal variable is dr. Okay, someone if calling dr.get, okay, what this will do, it'll check that what is the thread that is calling this. Okay, If the thread is thread one, it will return this. Okay. If the thread is thread two, it will return this. Okay. It internally has configuration like thread local map inside it, you know, do all the stuff for us, but it's beyond our scope. Okay. So maybe, if we get some time, maybe I'll take another video sometimes later, but for now we created a getter method. Now we also create a set method. Okay. Public static, and return type is void. I'm going to set the driver here, and to set the driver I need to tell dr dot okay set, but it's asking me web driver because we already told we are going to store web driver here. So whenever you are bringing the child to child care home, the parents need to bring the child with them, then only we can set it, right? So what I'm saying, I'm adding the parameter. Okay, someone is passing me maybe driver reference. Okay, I will assign it to child care home. Okay, as simple as that. This is enough for us. Okay, now but we already know we need to add one more method. Okay, that is for remove, to safely remove the whole stuff. Okay, so what I want to do, public static unload, again that is going to be of return type void. Okay, again, the reason why I named it as unload is because SonarLint used a word like unload. Okay, otherwise we would have used some convention that we never even thought about. Okay, we will normally clean up something like that we use, but it's a convention they are using like unload, so we are also using. So dr.remove, this is the three methods that we have created. This is one of the variable that we have created. So what we need to do, once we are going to office, so okay, before going to, after going to, while going to office, once you create the object for this, just assign it to call the set driver method. Okay, and then assign whatever the child you have with you to them. Okay, once you do that, whenever you want the child, okay, whenever you want to pick the child, you need to call the get driver method. Okay, get driver method. Wherever you want to, get the child, you have to just call get driver method. Again, guys, this is a comparison analogy that I have. So I have assigned the driver, whatever I created, to this particular, using this particular set driver to the thread local variable. Now this thread local variable will take care of, thread safety and other stuff. Okay. Again, instead of assigning it to null, what we can do, if you want to clean up some operation, previously I used to do like this. I used to tell set driver and then I will pass null. Okay, previously I used to do like this, but after SonarLint, okay, it is now telling me to use unload method. Okay, so unload. Okay, this method will whatever the value stored there, it will completely remove this. Okay, that's why we are using SonarLint. Okay, it will help us to write much better code. Now let me go to the my test cases. Okay, wherever I am using a driver, I need to update them as well. Again, now this driver variable is still displayed for me. So what I can do, I can make it as a private because I'm not using it anywhere outside my class. Wherever I'm going to use, this get driver method. Okay, so I can just tell get driver, right? It'll do the job for me. Copy this, go to your login page test and paste it here. Good. Now everything is set. Let's try to run the test. Okay, again, we will check once again whether the thread count is 2. Yes, thread count is 2 methods. Yeah, all good. Let's try to run the test now. This time this whole stuff should work. I'll just give a couple of seconds, maybe. Yeah, now both the Chrome driver instances got open. Notice, see, everything is working fine. Previously it was failing. Now after using this thread local variable, everything is resolved, right? So to quickly summarize, okay, we have something called a thread local, which will help us to and make sure that whatever the thread that is assigning it can only access it. If thread one goes, thread local make sure it will only return the driver one. It will never return driver two, which is created by thread two. Okay, to achieve this, we have only used three simple methods. Okay, get driver and set driver, and unload is to completely remove the value from the this particular thread local after you do all your operation. Okay, after you quit your divert, just unload it. Okay, so that this will be again back to null, so that next thread will, when it comes, it will pick it again, it will check for the condition. Everything is good now, right? So, but the thing is, again, I told this particular class is doing a lot of work here. Okay, so what I can do, you know, this particular thing is actually managing my driver, right? It's managing my driver to be thread safe. In our framework, we have a rule that, you know, we need to keep right thing in the right place, right? So what I can do, I can cut it, the whole thing, okay? And I have to create something related to driver management, right? So I cannot create it in the constants package. So I have to create it here. Right click, you know, click, you know, create a new class, name it as driver manager. Okay, once I create this class, I can place this whole thing there. Okay. Now I can come here. Instead of just a driver, I just need, since this is a static method, right? So I can just call it with call like this. Yeah. Wherever I want to use get driver, set driver, I just need to, you know, call like this, because the methods are now moved to a different place. Good. And even in my home page test, again, guys, this is, we haven't touched about this page layers. So we are writing the whole thing here, but once we create our page layers, this entire thing will be moved there. Okay. Sorry. Okay. And I think we should import the package. Yeah, it's from com.tmb driver. Okay, everything is fine. Let's save everything. Okay, I think everything is fine now. Let's again try to run the test. We just moved the things to the right place, right? So this is one of our rule. Okay, now both the browser got open. Okay. Good, all got paused. And we also have now a very clean driver class. And also we have a very good driver manager package, which manages the whole other stuff. Again, if you notice, my sonar lint is giving me a suggestion. See, add a private constructor to hide this implicit one. Okay. Since you are not allowing people to create any objects, I have not seen anyone creating an object for this. Why do you want to create it as a public constructor? That's why we can create this private driver manager. Okay. Good. Again, no one is extending. I don't want someone to extend this class and directly use getDriver. So what I can do, I can tell fine. Okay, so that nobody can extend this particular class. Okay, the same way, this thing, you know, I don't want someone to extend this. Okay, good. And I don't want someone to create an object for this outside this. Okay, all good now, right? Good. Now let's get back to something that we have, we saw about all these things, right? We saw how to create a thread local variable, how to get, set and remove methods, but we haven't seen what is the default value. Again, if you have not assigned some default value, you know, it will be null. Okay. Suppose before assigning this, if I print that, you know, thread local variable here. Okay. If I just call driver manager dot get driver here, it'll print me null. Okay. So this is the default value. So is there any way to, change the initial value? Okay. If there is any way to change the initial value. Yes, there are, you know, cases. If you want to change the initial value, you can do that. Again, the section, what I'm going to do now is completely optional. If you have a good understanding of Java, maybe you can watch this. Otherwise, I'll create a separate series for Java 8 anonymous classes, your functional interfaces, streams and lambdas. I'll create a separate series. We will anyways try to incorporate all those topics, but for now we'll just try to understand something that, you know, like this is possible. Okay, so what I have done, I have created something already. Okay. Okay. So this thread local class, right? Whatever the thread local class we are seeing for so long time is having is having a, sorry guys, I received a call. So is having some methods within it. So we already seen about three methods, but it's also have some method called as with initial, you know, which will accept directly this supplier interface. Again, if you know what is a functional interface, we can easily understand what is supplier. Again, if you do not know, there is another way, okay, another way where it has a method called initial value. Okay, it has a method inside, you know, this with the initial value, okay, somewhere here. And what you can do, you can just override the method to provide your own implementation, right? If you want to override a method, what you need to do, we need to extend the thread local class. Again, I'm going to pass the generic string, and if I'm just trying to override it, okay, I'm just trying to override the method that is available in the parent class, okay, with the initial value method, and I'm giving ABCD, which means instead of null as the default value, it can hold ABCD now. Okay, the same way, if you want to, you know, instead of creating a new class just for the purpose of overriding method, what you can do, you can simply create an anonymous class. Okay, if you already know about anonymous class, that's okay. But if not, anonymous class is something that doesn't have a name. Here, if you notice, we have a subclass which is having a name, thread local subclass demo. The purpose of this subclass is just to override this method. So instead of doing all this thing, what I have done, I have created the object already. Okay, this is the object that we are creating for thread local, but we are providing the implementation here. Okay, suppose something, we have a method, a block surrounding a method is a class, right? A block surrounding a method is class. Okay, so this is what called as anonymous, in an anonymous class, because the thing is, you know, we don't have a new class name here. Like in the previous case, we have a thread local subclass demo. Here, we don't have a new class. Okay. This class does not have any name. That's why we call it as nameless class or anonymous class. Okay. These are all things that are a little tricky to understand. Maybe I'll create a separate topic, separate series for us to understand. Okay. So what I've also done, I have also tried to use this in our thread local with the Selenium. Okay, so what I've done, I have created a thread local variable. Okay, and there is also a method called with the initial. Okay, so if you notice, instead of you creating anonymous inner class, doing all the other stuff, there is a method here. Okay, with the initial, this method is accepting a supplier implementation. Okay, supplier is a functional interface. Again, functional interface is an interface which has only one abstract method. Okay, again, we'll see that in a separate series, but for now you can just pass a supplier implementation directly here. Okay, what you can do, supplier interface, the method get method doesn't need any arguments, so I'm leaving it null, and we can provide the implementation in the block like this. Okay, so since this is multi-line lambda, so what I can do, so this is a lambda symbol, guys. So I am not receiving any parameters. I am creating a multi-line lambda. So I'm creating like this. And then inside this, you can set your system variable, system.set property. Okay. We have webdriver.chrome.driver, right? Chrome.driver. And the value is whatever the value you want to give. Okay. And you can also use return new Chrome driver instance. And your path will be definitely src, it is resources/executable/chrome-driver.exe. Okay, so this is how you can use your with initial method. So what I just want to tell only one thing, okay? Normally, it will have a default value of null, okay? But if you use with initial, or if you override the initial value method, then it will have a default value, whatever the default value you are telling. So in our case, now it will have a new Chrome driver as a default value. Again, this unload method, previously it will set it back to null. But in this case, it will set it back to default value, not the null. Okay, so this is the only thing that I want to tell. I'm also exploring options how we can use this initial value with the Selenium, but for now we just added knowledge for you guys. Okay, so, and I just want to touch base on one more topic, like inheritable thread local. This is also optional. Yeah, what happens, I'll try to explain this with the same example that we had before. We have thread local class, right? It's like a child care home. There is another child care home run by the same guys. Okay, what they have another child care home where if you, you know, you have some thread one, thread two, everything is fine. But this child care home will allow not only the parents, okay, not only the parents, but also their grandparents, okay, also their uncles, relatives, everything, everyone to go and collect their, you know, take their child back. Okay, in, if you want to understand in terms of Java, if there are child threads, okay, you can create multiple threads, right? From the thread one, I'm creating child thread of C1, C2, C3. Okay, anyone can, these four guys can go and, you know, control, read or write on this particular object. Okay, that's the inheritable thread local class. Again, in a Selenium perspective, we are not using it anywhere because we are not creating any, you know, child threads and stuff. We are using the testng default threads. Yeah, so it's just another knowledge. We will try to explore if we can use anything of this sort in our Selenium. But until then, you all have a very good day. If you are new here, please do subscribe to my channel. Thank you, guys.